discover what it's like to be free of all my demons, to be free of all my demons.
Oké, we zitten dus in een kravas, een meter op 15 ingevallen. Alles is verder oké. Hulpdiensten zijn onderweg, zijn er al. Ik heb een ijsschroef erin gezet voor mijn dubbele veiligheid. Ik zit vast aan het touw gaat naar boven naar Maarten. Maarten heeft goed werk geleverd. Een mooie sneeuwanker gebouwd. Nou, het zou mooi zijn dat we hier snel uit zijn. Eén, het is koud. And a little bit spooky. Alright, nou, het komt allemaal goed. Alles is oké. Hopelijk zijn we er snel uit.
About to go for my last run before leaving for Nepal. I've been training intensively for the last 12 weeks. It's been going very well, so I think I should be fit enough to attend Manaslu Noax. As you can see, bags are packed. This afternoon I'm picking up Max, and tomorrow we're leaving for Nepal. Yo, Max.
Is goed?
Ja, best. Met jou?
Ja, lekker.
Mark, wat ben je aan het doen?
Ik ben merchandise aan het maken voor mijn enige sponsor.
Nou, is niet je enige sponsor, toch?
Mijn enige zakelijke sponsor. Dus dat er op de volgende expeditie maar meer mogen zijn.
Nou, daar gaat ie.
Right, we are at Amsterdam Airport looking to check in. Flying to Istanbul first and then on to Kathmandu, where we will arrive a couple days early, but we'll hang around town, get the latest things, and we'll be ready to get into the mountains.
Now it's time to get to the hotel.
So this is not the hotel we would typically stay in. It's a 5-star hotel. Max at the top floor, trying to show all his stuff. It's got a view. Sadly, the swimming pool is empty. But hey, this guy's working hard already. We are making some pictures. Anything for the gram. From the streets of Kathmandu. We arrived here yesterday. From here we will start our journey to the top of Manaslu, which should happen in about 5 weeks from now. But until then, we have some time to spare in Kathmandu, about 4 days, before we start to hike to Manaslu base camp. So what do? Well, we sort our gear. We kind of did that this morning. We also have to get some patches printed, which is not easy to do. We need to find some Velcro for on our summit suits, then have it printed, pick it up. We just met Christina Rilla, the girl who is doing all the 8,000 meter peaks in less than 6 months, I think. Well, it's fun to see her here. We met her on our journey to Island Peak last time. So it's nice to meet again. And right now we are looking for some coffee and some food. Max, wat hebben we net gedaan?
Briefing.
Ah ja. Je moet gaan ondertitelen. Sorry.
Breakfast.
It's the night before we leave. So tomorrow morning, early, we will leave. And it's time for a little weigh-in. All right, so 67, that's an absolute record for me. We'll see how much it is after the expedition.
Well, that's it. Climbing, enjoy the mountain.
Thank you. Walking in the town of Bessisauer, a place that feels quite tropical. It's at lower elevation, only about 800 meters. I actually been here before when I started Annapurna circuit a couple years back. Today we will take jeep to Darapani, and from there our trek to Manaslu base camp will finally start. I'm ready for it. It's been a couple of days, so well rested, should be good. Fall over here, and they're working to clean up the road, but it's causing some delay. Basically, we made it into the mountains. We're gonna start trekking tomorrow, making our way towards Manaslu base camp. Well, I'm just gonna show you where we are. It's quite beautiful already. Alright, what you see here is no bridge. I've been here a couple years back and I know for sure that I crossed the bridge here. Well, apparently it's been swept away. That's why we have to walk around for maybe 3 kilometers. It's alright, we got plenty of time, but we're finally hiking. We hiked today to Goa. It's the first day of hiking, but still a long way to Manaslu base camp. Anyway, they got some funny things growing here. But it's not time for that. Well, tomorrow we'll continue hiking towards the next village, which will be at a bigger elevation. We will acclimatize over there for a day. And after that, we'll hike onwards over Larki Pass, and then onwards to Manaslu base camp. What are those, Ivan?
Yaks!
Yak! Hey guys! We made it! So that was our hike for day number 2. Made it to Bintang. And friends are here already. Alright, let's see what this place has to offer. Acclimatization day. We hike to a lake. These guys crazy, they want to ski down.
Namaste! Inshallah, we can ski.
Yeah, they hope to ski down Manaslu, yeah, which is awesome. I'll let you know how it goes in the video.
Nice. If the snow conditions is good, maybe we can ski well.
Yeah.
If no, maybe.
We will see. Inshallah, right?
First the summit and after.
All right, awesome. Yeah. We're just gonna hang out here for a bit and enjoy our day. First light on this early morning. We are crossing Larkela Pass today, and we started out at 3 o'clock, and apparently it's about 6 more hours of nothing. She's taking care of him.
Hi, Richard.
Why did he make my so dry?
It's a first class spot on the way down. He's smoking us out. Better pack my bag quick and on to Samagong.
That is Little Richard, and Little Richard's been hiking with us ever since one of the first towns of our trek, towards Manaslu Base Camp. He even came over the pass with us yesterday, had to be carried though, but he's probably gonna come with us to base camp, and where he's gonna be treated well. Anyway, a little update on the hike towards base camp. We went over the Larkalap pass yesterday, and that's where altitude sickness kind of hit me. It feels like the hangover from hell, death and destruction. But as you can see, I'm fine right now. And I hope this helps with acclimatization. And it has to prove itself once we go up to the higher camps of Manaslu. Everything's going great, and we're heading to Samagong. That's where we go tonight, and it's somewhere over there. It's probably very pretty. So, this is the day before we head up to base camp, which is right over there, but sadly it's in the clouds. Well, let's hope this guy behind us will allow us to climb Mount Manaslu. So far it's looking very good. You start climbing during the rainy season, that's why we don't get to see the mountain yet. For about 2 weeks in the end of September, early October, the jet stream actually lifts and the clouds clear up, and you should get a good window to climb Manaslu, and that's what we're heading for. So next stop, base camp, and we will start rotating to acclimatize and then finally to the top.
We're having a coffee break on our hike to base camp. How are you doing, Robbie?
I had geen zin om erin te gaan.
Coffee. And Richard's on his way as well.
Now I'm going to film you. What do you think about the trek?
It's pretty muddy. But at least there's less donkey shit now. Well, it's starting to rain actually, so it's nice to be inside.
And are you excited to go to base camp?
Finally? Yeah, super excited. We've been hiking for a week or so, I think, right now.
Uh-huh.
And ready for base camp.
That's
and
good.
Like, hit some ice. How about you, Robbie?
I've been thinking for 6 years to be now, so I'm really excited to be here. Full of sunblock.
We're gonna look great with some luck.
So after all those days hiking, we made it to Manaslu base camp. So this is my tent, just getting it ready. But yeah, you're gonna need some decorations.
December, yeah.
It has been snowing this morning, so we're still waiting for the weather to clear up a bit. I guess we just have to deal with it and get some coffee. Getting ready for this puja, where they will bless our materials and us, and ask for permission to actually climb this mountain. So the lama is here. And yeah. Good morning from Manaslu Base Camp. I would like to share this moment with you because this is the first moment in maybe 48 hours it's not raining. Weather's still not great. I would have loved to actually show you Manaslu on the background, but sadly, weather still has to clear up, and that also keeps us in base camp. Most we can do is practice a little bit with ropes and ice. But there's no climbing yet. We have to wait for better weather. So, wearing these shoes. And this is a bad weather day, but I didn't want to do nothing at all. So I went up to just over 5,000 meters. Over here, start to need using a rope. I don't want to do that on these shoes and wearing my umbrella. So this can be it for today. We've been invited to Nim's party later today. So I'm gonna head on down and go there, crash the party.
Come on, come on.
I was sitting here in my home, my tent in base camp. It's been raining for the last 3 days, but tomorrow finally weather's gonna clear up and we will start our first rotation. Yeah, I'm just happy getting out of the tent and having some dry conditions for the first time, and also getting up the mountain ready for it, definitely. For now today, it's still gonna be rainy. Just trying to keep the water out of my tent. And also getting all my shit ready for tomorrow. In full gear, we are about to leave for our first rotation. Sleeping in camp one, first night, and moving on to camp two, sleep there. And then either touch camp three or sleep in camp three, and then come back to base camp and finish our first rotation. Well, let's go. We're at Crampon Point. On our way to camp one, finally moving. Rain turned into snow, which is a relief. And yeah, feels good to finally be up the mountain, going up, acclimatizing, and then returning to base camp, where we will be getting ready for our summit push afterwards.
Aangekomen in kamp 1. Even lekker bakje doen. Was ja, af en toe wel. Laatste stukje was wel wat pittiger omhoog.
Laatste stukje was intens. Hallo
Martin. Zeg eens Maarten.
But we have Oreo now.
Oh, maybe later. Ja, even bakje doen. En dan ga ik lekker even mijn matje uitklappen, mijn domspak aantrekken en even, even liggen. Ja, en dus de rest van de dag gewoon lekker mixen en morgen door naar kamp 2.
Dit is onze buurman Ilan. We hebben nog geen burenruzie.
Hard luk erbij.
Dit is onze casa.
Daar staat Maarten nog.
Maarten.
Oreo.
Hey guys, it's a tent building crew. So this is camp one. Good morning. Woke up camp one. We both feel like shit. Didn't sleep for like, well, not the way we're supposed to. Hey, then again, like, that's what they kind of promised us. I wonder if the other guys feel like shit too. How do we feel, guys? Great!
Yay!
Well,
I've had better nights.
There's Lewis in the clouds, but look at those views. Today we are getting ready to move to camp 2. supposedly the most technical part of the whole climb. Max, you looking forward to this? We had a pretty rough night. We, well, quite honest, we feel like shit. But hey, that's the life of a mountaineer, I guess. Yeah.
I'm on a journey to discover what it's like to be free of all my demons, to be free of all my demons. Was it gonna affect me?
A little bit of a bottleneck here. Going up steep, you need to use Jumar. And I just slipped like 4 meters down because my Jumar wouldn't hold on the thin rope. So I guess I'll be using the thick ropes if present. We'll see. At least the sun is shining. Okay. Stop there, Paul. Prime target, the East Pinnacle. Getting pretty crowded in camp too. Time for an update. Was a pretty heavy hike up here. Like, I'm not gonna lie to you. Normally when ultra running and stuff, like you kind of feel like you have like magical powers, and that's all gone here. Anyway, we made it to camp two. The sun's going down on the East Pinnacle of Manaslu. We're gonna try to sleep here. It's not gonna be easy because sleeping at altitude is, well, not as easy as you think. We will try anyway. And after that, we will try to continue onwards to camp 3. And I'm probably gonna go back down after that to base camp, recover a little bit, and then go back up. Morning from camp 2. Some of the guys feel like shit, decide to go down. We're gonna head up to camp 3 and just catch a little bit more altitude and then go back down. On the way to camp 3, I think the Jumaring is actually making this harder. We're nearing camp 3, 10 minutes. Well, there's a lot of clouds, but the view's spectacular. Made it, camp 3. As of the plan, I'm just gonna touch it and go back down. As you can tell, like, I don't have much clothes on. Anyway. Camp 3 is not as big as the other camps. Big Kurai, Quebec. Yeah, interesting. Gonna be sleeping here before the summit push. It's gonna be a long, long day. For me now, gonna go back down base camp. Hey Max.
Oh.
Finally found some sun.
Drying all my shit.
So we can dry some shit. Lots of avalanches coming down. Yeah, obviously the weather hasn't been so great. But yeah. We finally get the chance to dry our shit. And here's a quick peek in my messy tent. Yeah. Well, that's just the way it is. Let's see what everybody else is doing.
I'll put it on top of my tent.
I have like a long one.
Let's do a little tour through Basecamp. Basecamp's really big this year. I've been told, I've never been here before, but well, I just spin the camera around, you'll see. It's quite big. In a way, let me take you on this quick tour. Because there's a bakery in which you can get like free all kinds of pastries. It's really nice. One of the good features over here, there's also a coffee shop in which you can get quality coffee. It's a bit crowded over here, but it's really nice to sit down and just have some coffee. Sun's going down, but this is one of the first nights where we can actually see the east pinnacle of Manaslu. I'll show it to you. It's right over there. If we walk down a little bit further over here, you can actually see our encampment down there. Up there you have elite expats with nymphs and those climbers. If you want to go up towards camp one, you can take the trail. I'll show you. This is the bakery, by the way. You take the trail up there behind that rock into the clouds, and over there there's camp one, and upwards camp two, further up camp three, then behind the pinnacle you have camp four. You can't actually see the top from here, too bad, but I'm sure I will show you once we start our summit attempt, and that should be in a couple of days from now. Stay tuned.
Jezus, nu heeft ze veel pijn gehad.
This is Max, he's in pain. What's going on, Max?
I don't know, step wrong. I've got like, I don't know how many more painkillers to kill a horse, some injections, but still feels like shit.
His neck is stuck. Doctor's been here. Doctors gave him a couple injections in his ass. Makes me wonder if he's a real doctor. But anyway, Max is still in pain and we hope it's getting better.
I know one thing for sure, tomorrow's summit pushes off the table.
You think? That's Max. Max has a neck injury, so he's forced to leave. Been waiting for a helicopter for 24 hours. A lot of shit went down last couple of days. Avalanche came down right there, leaving people injured. One fatality. Anyway, I'm still pushing for the summit. Leaving tomorrow. Hope to be on the summit by Saturday or so.
Going.
Cheers. Right. It was Max taking off. Unfortunately, he had to give up due to a neck injury. The mountain's been fucking with my mind last couple of days. Helicopter blew my cap off. Anyway, avalanche came down, leaving one dead and several injured. Leaving me in doubt whether I should continue or not. But after some good conversations back home with Arnold, our expedition leader, I decided to continue. I'll be setting off tomorrow morning to camp 2 at once. Going up there, staying there for the night. Then going up to camp 3, and hopefully in the night start our real summit push. Hope to be on the summit on Saturday. Come all the way back down. So I'm going down to our camp right now to pack my bag for the summit push. And while the showdown is starting, I might as well introduce you to who's left. This here, Hector.
Hey.
From Mexico. He's leading the other Mexicans.
Indeed.
Up there, and I'm probably learning a lot from him too. Elon came back from Samagón for the summit push. And here's the big boss,
yeah,
Arnold Coster.
I kind of live here.
Het Sherpa, Dawa. Guys, let's do this. On our summit push, camp one. It's like a lunch break. I just point the camera at those mountains over there because I haven't seen those before. Here he is, pretty steep. Climb straight up. Behind there, camp 3. I think maybe like 2 more couloirs or so. Well, having my ass handed to me, but hey, what do you expect on an 8,000 meter peak? Broke my pants, that's okay, it's worth it. Here comes Sinduk as well. Well, let's continue. Quite a big crew in here.
Hi.
We know all these guys. These guys don't give a shit. Like, they walk up the mountain like it's nothing. A very love, respect. Show you what's going on, camp 2. Lots of wind up there.
Good morning.
Here's Louise and Luke behind there. So it seems we will be waiting for another day in camp 2 for the weather to be better, or the wind to calm down, really. We gotta look what we're doing today, because I think it'd be pretty much nothing.
It's gonna be a very boring day.
But at least we have snow.
To play.
Right.
Hey, Dawa, this is Arnold, go ahead.
Okay, Arnold, then I'm Martin, talk with you, man.
Okay, go ahead.
Hey, Arnold, Martin
here. Hey, Martin, hoe gaat ie?
Ja, weinig energie. Vandaag van 2 naar 3 gekomen. En dat ging eigenlijk echt voor gemeten. En daar onderweg eigenlijk besloten op te geven. Ja, die beslissing is in mijn hoofd genomen, zeg maar. Ik heb er vrede mee. Ik verlies niet alleen het fysieke spelletje, ook het mentale spelletje hier. Dus beter om gewoon naar beneden te gaan nu.
Ja,
Ik denk als je naar beneden wil, dan is het beste om gewoon sowieso al naar beneden te gaan.
Over. Vandaag nog dus.
Ja, je mag natuurlijk ik kan een kopje drijven, maar dat is een leuke nacht, denk ik. Als je klaar gaat, dat je beetje klaar.
Dan gaan we dat proberen. Als jij denkt dat dat haalbaar is voor binnen afzienbare tijd, dan doen we dat gewoon.
De vraag is hoeveel uur?
Ja, toen Ivan naar beneden ging was het 4 uur. Maar je hoeft natuurlijk niet helemaal laag te halen, maar zo ver mogelijk. Een beetje denk ik. En Max had het over een luchtmatje en een high-tech die nog in kant 1 ligt. Weet jij wat hij bedoelt?
Ik weet wel welke hij heeft, dus ik kan kijken of die daar liggen.
Ook als jij naar beneden gaat, kan je dan checken of er naar beneden komt.
Gaan we doen, tot later vanmiddag.
Oké, laat je Sherpa ons op de hoogte houden. Dan sturen we een kitchen boy omhoog tegemoet naar kamp 1.
Is goed, thanks. All right, man, thank you. So, going down now. Yeah. That's pretty crazy. Like, electric storm coming over. I don't know if I should be happy or not that I'm back in base camp. May not be raining in camp 3. Snowing. I know. Anyway, I'm gonna kick some snow off the roof so it has collapsed.
Inside
is better.
Oh,
10 meters. 10 meters. 10 meters. 10 meters.
Okay.
Look at my hair. Just had a kind of big avalanche coming down from there. And this is not how I want to end this expedition, but it marks the danger of being here right now. We all survived. There's Arnold smiling about it. Well, it was kind of a cool experience, also a bit scary. Anyhow, I'm going down in maybe an hour or so. Had to end my expedition, didn't feel strong enough. I don't think anybody's gonna summit, but we'll see. All right, reporting to you from the mountains for one last time. Currently hiking down in the snow. It's been snowing very bad last night, and an avalanche just struck base camp while I was in it, packing my bag, causing everybody on the mountain to quit this expedition. So it's over, not only for me, for everyone. I was hoping for it to have a better outcome, but the mountain decides, and we're just ants on this hill. Been on this mission to climb this mountain, Manaslu. It's been my mission for a year and a half, maybe 2 years. Failed to climb the mountain, made it to camp 3, came down yesterday, but right now we got the shocking news that Dawachiri, our head Sherpa, is missing. Stay strong, buddy, you can make it out alive. There's a rescue mission going on, Saw a helicopter going up these two camp two. Hope they get to long line and actually salvage these three brave Sherpas who've been doing all this work for us. Really, just would be possible to climb this mountain without these guys. And here I am, back in the Netherlands. A lot of people have been asking me if I'm sad or disappointed with the outcome of the expedition, and to tell you the truth, not at all. It's been an epic adventure, and well, despite the outcome, when you start these kind of things, you're never quite sure if you're gonna make the summit, and I think this year, especially, the weather was not on our hands at all, which was making it difficult to get acclimatized properly to even go for a summit push. So there was a narrow weather window. We tried to go for it anyway. But yeah, well, sadly, I had to throw in the towel at a certain point. Well, and then of course there's Dava Chiring, was our lead Sherpa. He died in an avalanche, and yeah, that, well, it sucks to lose anyone on a mountain, but especially when it's one of the guys of your team, like a guy you grew friends with. Yeah, it's really sad for his family and him. I think a funding action is being set up by Mike Posner, actually. I don't know the details yet, but I'll put them in the description later, so you can donate if you want to help his family set up like a college scholarship or something. I'll let you know. Well, and of course, when you climb big mountains like this, there's always this risk, and sadly, Dava became victim to this. Then there's a lot of people who ask me, are you gonna do this again? And I definitely want to, but the thing is, these things cost a lot of money, and it's proven to be hard to find sponsors. So maybe if you want to sponsor me for a next expedition, like, please let me know. And I also want to say thank you to all the people who supported me on the crowdfunding I set up for this one. Yeah, it helped me a big deal, and I want to say special thanks to Interactive Culture, who, well, actually put in the most in the crowdfunding. So yeah, thanks. You know who you are, guys. Thanks. So I'm not sure yet when I'll be back in the mountains. One thing I do know, next summer we will try Matterhorn, but also I will be focusing on running from now on for the next couple of months. Next summer I wanna join, or well, sign up to PTL or Tour de Géants. Those are really, really big time races in Chamonix or in Italy. Yeah, we're just trying to figure out the details and try to get in, and those are both 300 kilometer plus races, so it's gonna be a tough one. Well, if you wanna follow me on any of those adventures, please hit subscribe, and you'll be the first one to know if I've done something again.
Nice.
Easy, Richard.